Hey, what's up there, guys? This is Adi here, and today I'm doing a post-commentary voiceover for my RE5 segmented run on the Xbox 360. This run is currently second place on the 360. First place is RE Snow. Snow has a 110-20, and I have a 110-29 officially, but really and truly, I have a 110-28. We had some mishaps on Chapter 3-2 that allowed me to, or didn't allow me, I guess, to get my 28. So I'll get into that when I get to that chapter. But here for this first chapter, I'm just going to do a little bit of talking about, you know, why we did this, where it's placed, and et cetera, just some info on the run, because this first chapter has not really got any big kind of tricks to it, so I'm just going to talk through this. So the whole reason we did this was because Snow wanted to get a 110 something, just 110XX, that's what he wanted. And at the time, you know, I had done a couple chapters with him, Outrage had done a lot with him, who else? We had CryingWolf do a bunch with them. There were several different people, but his goal was always to get, like, a 110, you know, 30, I think, was, like, his goal back in the day. And at the time, he had a 111. And we were like, you know what? Let's just get this done. So during the summer, I decided to really buckle down and help him. And for, like, a month or month and a half or something like that, we grinded this game to oblivion. So this... My run, you know, my whole run wasn't a thing then. I didn't plan to have a segmented run. It was just, you know, I was helping Snow and we were going to get him a time. But in doing so, I myself had good times because, you know, I was getting him good times. So in the end, I was just like, well, I might as well just make this a thing. I mean, I'm close enough anyways. I have all these chapters done, so why not? So, June 12th was the actual last day that we stopped playing. I think we had started in May. June 12th was the actual last day that me and Snow had stopped. And that was the day that we had the mishap on 3-2, where I lost my second, but he got his second. But the last day that my run was actually done was on August 7th. I took a long break, and then I was like, you know, I might as well just finish this, and there was only one chapter I needed to do. And that chapter was 2-3, and had to get a one cycle. So I was like, I might as well just finish this and just post it and then do post-commentary for it. So that's what we're doing now. So that's a little background of, you know, why this run happened. As you can see on this first chapter here, I've got the Carpenter with me. We actually get a 8:19, which is the second fastest time. It is the fastest recorded time. There's several people that have this, including Snow and Crying Wolf. I think Outrage has one. But the actual fastest time for 1-1 is an 8:18 that was done by Snow and Crying Wolf. The only reason that it's not quote-unquote official is because Crying Wolf disconnected right there at the end. And so it gave Snow the 8:18, but it didn't give Crying Wolf. Same thing happened to us on 3-2. So we know that he got it, and that's one reason, like, his time... Like, he has a second on everyone else, unlike me and Outrage and Crying Wolf. But, he counts the 8:19 as, you know, the official one, but we still marked the 8:18 as a thing, and I think he still has the video for it when he got it, but Zach, you know, disconnected, so. What else? Let's see. We were comparing a lot of our times to Resi Runner. If you guys don't know who Resi Runner is, he is one of the best RE5 players. Plays on PS3. And a lot of his times were a basis for us to go off of. The PS3 and the Xbox are, like, really, really close in times. You can compare them pretty similarly. The only difference is, you know, they play on PAL, and there is PAL and NTSC differences in certain sections. I ended up getting a PAL Xbox towards the very end of our seg run stuff, so that helped with some of the levels that we needed to get done, as we were able to actually play on PAL. But for the most part, all the other times are really comparative, and we used his as a basis. So I'm not sure exactly what his end time is, like his total end time is, but I know it's got to be something close to, you know, our times, like the 110 something. For his 1-1 on PS3, as far as I know, he has an 820, and as I said, me and Carpenter here get an 819. 818 is the fastest you can get. What else? As you can see here, we're freezing these guys. The reason we froze those guys there is so that when the executioner comes, he will swing early and break the fence. You also want the executioner to come quickly. This is like the only trick really in 1-1 that even is a thing that we try and do. So you see he shot a flasher there. That flash is to aggro the executioner, and then he sees those guys are there. So he sees the guys at the fence, so he swings at them, and it inadvertently breaks the fence as well. Breaking the fence and us getting through that fence area is actually what starts, you know, the timer for this area to go away. So we want him to come as quickly as possible and break that fence. We ended up just decided to play it safe for the rest of the run and just like go up top. I don't think we went down and tried to kill anyone because we were just like, you know, let's not have any mess ups and accidentally like, you know, kill each other or something stupid. So we just go up top. It's safe up there. So another thing I want to mention is, you know, some of you guys may have seen that Comchick has the time, and, you know, he says he has the world record. He doesn't have the overall world record. That belongs to Snow. But he does have overall the second fastest time, but he plays on Steam, and his run, frankly, is not very good. He played on 60/30 frames per second with his partner, and Steam is loads faster than the Xbox or the PS3 when it comes to real time and in-game time. Playing on higher frame rates affects both, not just real time, not just like your loads in between chapters and such. But for some reason, it actually messes with in-game time as well. So playing on 60 frames per second or 120, aka unlocked frames per second, actually makes it go quicker. So, you know, he may have like a comparable time, say on a chapter, but that's just because they have a faster system. It's not because he played as well. So we actually play better than he does. But he just has a, you know, comparable time. So had we go, you know, if we go and play on Steam, or had we played on Steam here, we would have had a 109 easily, like no question. But that's just the nature of the beast. So, you know, one of these days we'll probably play on Steam and get the crazy, you know, 109, 108 stuff. And we obviously don't do any glitches. This is a glitchless segmented run. There are some glitches we could have used, such as the one in 2-2, which saves like a second. We could have, if we, you know, were like super crazy, done the fire glitch where, you know, you play on LAN and you delete your cache so that there's no like patches or updates or anything like that, and then you can do the fire glitch in 3-2, and that saves a lot of time, like over a minute, I'm pretty sure. But yeah, this is glitchless. It is New Game Plus, obviously, as you can tell. But we had to play on normal, which is not fun. Normally, you know, if you're doing a seg run, you would want to play on amateur. It makes the enemies easier. just makes life easier in general, because there's a lot of things that are different on normal, especially 2-3 when you have to one cycle the Gigante. One cycling the Gigante is actually one of the hardest things to do, like, ever, period, on anything when it's on normal. There's only been, to my knowledge, two teams that have ever one cycled Gigante on normal, on 360, or anything in general that's on normal. And that was Snow and Outrage, and me and JCStrickland, and that's it. Those are the only two teams that have ever done it. On amateur, you know, it's really easy to one cycle, but on normal, it's almost impossible. It's bad. So that was our 1-1. We get 8-19. And that's, you know, quote unquote tied for the world record for 1-1. 8-18 is still the fastest, though. So now we're moving on to chapter 1-2. And as you can see, in between each of these chapters, I show who I'm inviting or who's inviting me to the game. Just so there's no, like, you know, some people are like, oh, no, you didn't show this, or you didn't show your inventory, or something, something, you must be cheating. Like, we made sure to record everything that we did, just so, you know, there was no, none of that kind of talk. So now you can see I'm playing with Snow. Down at the bottom left, you have the logos for each person. You may see my logo change throughout the video. It's just because of when we recorded. I used to have a different logo. But you'll be able to tell who's playing, and I'll tell you who's playing. So I'm usually always Sheva. Sheva is my main character. Carpenter and Snow and JC all play Chris. They are Chris mains. I'm a Sheva main, so it works out. I mean, I can play Chris. We can pretty much all of us. Well, not all of us, but for sure, me and Snow can play either character really well. He is probably, I'd say he's the number one Chris player. He's basically the best player at the game. There's a guy named Bronin, who is basically the GOAT of RE5. He's like the number one best player, but he hasn't played in many, many years. And he was the one who taught Snow. He was his master, quote unquote. And then we've got Trance, who is also really good. Trance and Snow are by far the best Chris players right now. But Bronin is, quote-unquote, the GOAT. Snow's told me that I'm the best Sheva player. Don't know if I actually believe that. And as you can see there on this, we just quit. This is a saving quit strat, so like if you do this where you switch hosts, some parts are different. We're having to play on Xbox Live, obviously, and because of that, like if we were playing on LAN, our loads and everything else would be way faster. We would have better times. If you play on LAN for the entirety of the game, like you shave off seconds just from doing nothing, just from having faster loads and not having host be a thing. There's lots of situations where, say I'm kicking someone through a door and I'm the host, it'll act a certain way, but if I'm not the host and I'm kicking someone through the door, it'll act different. There's just certain situations. So we felt that it was best to switch here just because of who has to kick who through doors and who gets to certain switches, you know, first. Based on that, because there's a delay on certain items, like if you're trying to hit X on that elevator like I just did and I was not host, it would have taken longer to hit because it would have taken longer to recognize me hitting it. Just certain things like that. So we do a lot of host swaps throughout this run, and I'll try to point them out as we go, but I had forgot that we did that one, so I had to kind of just interrupt myself and tell you guys what was going on or why we were doing that. So Snow's, yeah, he's told me I'm the best Sheva player. Like I said, I don't know if I believe that. I would say I'm top five right now, but like, I don't know. I mean, it's just hard. It's hard to judge that type of thing. It's really, it's hard to judge who's best at what, like when you're not playing like head-to-head against people or whatever. We're indirectly competitive when it comes to speedrunning, so it's hard to tell that kind of stuff. So there's nothing really special with 1-2 either. That's why I was decided to, you know, just talk through this. The end time that we get here, I believe, it's 1 second slower than the world record. The world record is by Snow and CryingWolf, I believe. And they get a 251. So we should get a 252 here. So Snow obviously didn't save this one. That's why I only have my side of the screen. Yeah, 252. So 251's the fastest. That's why he just deleted his, so I don't have his side. If you see one that's just full screen like this, that means that I don't have the other person's side, and it was either because it was deleted or just wasn't recorded, wasn't needed, whatever. But that's why. It's just because he has a faster time, so he didn't need this one. So now we're going into 2-1. Funny story about this one. This is me and Snow doing this. I want to say the record at the time was a 3:32. Let me check and see if I can find that. Okay, so Resi Runner has a 3:30. Which is also what we get on this. However, going into it, Snow's best time was, I believe, 3:32. It may have been 3:31, but I want to say it was 3:32 with Outrage. This grenade throw is actually really cool. It's really precise. You gotta throw it really quick, too. And it breaks both tripwires, and we're able to get through. So that's pretty neat. And then here coming up, I gotta shoot a rocket through this door, this car window at a certain point. It didn't kill the dog, which was kind of weird, but we still got there pretty quick. It wasn't flawless. But anyways, this was our very first try. Mine and Snow's very first try at this chapter. We had not done it any times before, and our first try, we ended up beating his time by 2 seconds, which was crazy. We were like, what? So we were pretty happy about that. Pretty happy. So this part, I don't know how we did it, but we did it first try, getting through this part. There's a lot of archers right here at the end, and somehow, like, you know, I guess him and Outrage had a lot of trouble getting through this part, but for some reason we were able to get through it first try, and we were like, what? And that, okay, like, we'll take that. But, yeah, this chapter's got some, it's got maybe like 3 or 4 different cool things. Like, you saw Snow just shoot me into the cutscene, and we actually did that on 1-1 as well. Shot the Carpenter into the cutscene, but my shot was really bad on that, by the way. But, and as you can see, we kick each other through doors and such too, which I'll talk about. But shooting each other through the cutscenes just kind of gives you a boost through the cutscene to make it activate quicker, because you want the checkpoint. That's what I meant to say, checkpoint, sorry. And then you can restart the checkpoint. You can see we're host swapping here. We wanted Snow to be host at this point for reasons. We just felt it was better. But either way, we kick each other through doors just like you saw. Reason we do this is because, you know, we've got to kick the door anyways. So why not have the other person try and get, like, farther ahead if we can? And kicking each other through doors can be hard, especially when Sheva has to kick Chris through. And as you can see, he's shooting this rocket. This rocket's actually going inside the house. He aimed, like, at a specific point. He goes inside the house to knock that key down. And then I'm able to grab it instead of having to shoot it down myself. He also shut the lock off for me and then holds that door open for me. So just certain things like this. This is where the co-op aspect comes into play. There's a lot of a lot of things where, you know, we'll hold the door open for each other, kick each other through doors. We actually also did this first try, too. Normally, you know, one of us would get shot, or him in Outrage, I guess, we used to get shot a lot. But for some reason, we were able to get through this first try, too. It was really strange. Like, this run was kind of the god run, I guess, like, just for, you know, doing it first try. But we have written down that we can still save a second on this run, and we believe we can because I grabbed the key slow, and also, what was the other part? It's towards the end, I believe. You can actually shoot Sheva through the checkpoint. We ended up not doing that because, you know, so this is the only time you're going to see the Gatling gun in this run. The Gatling gun, man. Okay, so reason he switches to the Gatling gun here is just to break a lock. There is a lock on this door coming up, and you can actually break it from the other side, and that's what we end up doing. It's just faster to use the Gatling gun, and you'll see it right here. So it breaks it and kicks me through. You can use electric rounds, you can use a grenade round, you can throw a grenade from the other side. There's a bunch of different things you can do to break it, but that's the fastest way we found. And he doesn't actually run with the actual Gatling gun itself out, because that's way slower. You run really slow with that. So, he runs with either a grenade or a regular gun. Like you see, he's using a grenade launcher. Us getting on that door was a little slow, too, so that's why we think we can save a second. On chapters 1-1 and 1-2, comparing to the best times that we have, which is, the 8-18 and then the 2:51 by Snow and Crying Wolf, we don't think we can save any time at all. We think those are, like, completely dead at this point. But this chapter, we think we can still save a second. So it's not perfect. This segrun is not perfect. We have in total 21 seconds we believe we can save off of Snow's times. And this is the part right here where, you know, we could have shot me through, but it's just kind of, we were like, I don't think we need it, so we didn't do it. By the way, 21 seconds. We think we can save 21 seconds in total off of Snow's time completely. And that would end up giving him a 109.59. So literally just barely a 109. And that would be insane. But we don't know if that's ever going to happen or if we're even going to try that. I think we said, okay, so yeah, 330. I think we said the only reason we would ever attempt to beat his time at this point, the 110.20, is if we play LAN. Because if we play LAN, we can save time, like a lot of time. But, you know, that requires us to get together. He lives, you know, in Kentucky. I'm in Oklahoma. You know, we'd have to fly out, drive out, something for a while. Get these times. So he kicked me through that door. I didn't get the fast kick, though. There's an animation where I actually get through it quicker. I got the slow one, quote-unquote. And then he shoots both my tripwires, which those shots are actually kind of hard to get right. And you can see, like, whenever I tried to go up that ladder, it took a second. That's just from Xbox Live delay. It's like, we'll hit it, but, like, it takes a second, like, right there. I'm spamming X, obviously, but I take this hit on purpose. It's actually faster, because if not, I have to jump out of the minecart, and I'm waiting, and then, you know, Chris is waiting on me. Rather than me waiting on him. So that's why we do that. So this is the advanced darkness section of the run. We do some stupid stuff too. You'll see we just swapped like weapons and whatever else, just gave each other a first aid or something. I don't know. We do a lot of memes throughout this run. You saw in 1-1 like me and Carp ate some eggs. Just random stupid stuff. But this is the advanced darkness area from SpongeBob from Rock Bottom. You can see like my capture kind of messes up here. And also I don't have Snow's side, reason being him and Outrage have a faster time by 1 second, I believe. But we go through this without the lantern. You could potentially do it with the lantern and not lose any time, we think. But this is a safer bet if we just do it this way to, you know, make sure we've got a good time. So I flash all those guys so we can get past. This part's probably the hardest to navigate right here, because it's complete dark right there. Like, there's just no tracks or anything to follow, but, you know. It's whatever. So anyways, Resi Runner, let's see what Resi Runner's time is on this chapter. He has a 347. I think we end up getting the 348 on this run. The fastest, you know, that him and Outrage have is also 347, just like Resi Runner. But like I said, you know, Resi Runner's on PS3, PAL, and on amateur. We're on Xbox and TSC and normal, so we have a harder time. But we make do with what we got. We still think we can save a second on this run. We have written down that we think we can save a second. So 346 is probably possible. But it would be, you know, just like any other set ground, extremely hard. And you may notice throughout this run, some of the clips I have don't have audio. And that is because there was a day where I had started recording with my Elgato, just using the Elgato software, and didn't notice that for some reason the checkbox for analog audio for, you know, an outside source of audio, if I could talk, outside source audio, you know, something you've plugged in to use for audio, was checked, and I was like, well, no, I wanted to use the Elgato's, you know, audio, like, what is this? But I didn't notice, and this particular day, we did, like, three different segments, and for some reason we were able to just get them done. Normally, you know, we would spend a day doing a segment and just never get a run and just, you know, move on to a different segment. But for some reason this day was a really good day, and we just got, you know, three different segments done really quick. But I didn't notice that all the captures had that checkbox mark, so some of the audio is gone, and I don't have Snow Side because obviously he's got a faster time, or he just, you know, deleted it or whatever. So we just have to make do with, you know, the video, and it's unfortunate, but oh well. The audio is not, like, super important, but that is why. So, just letting you know. So we're about to get the quick kill on Bat Lago. We call him Bat Lago. His name's not actually Bat Lago. It's like Popa Karimu or something like that. We get the quick kill on him, which is actually pretty neat. You just gotta shoot before the cutscene, and for some reason the rockets stay during the cutscene, and you just you kill him. You hit him in the air and he goes down. There's a lot of times though where you'll hit him with the rocket and he won't die. He'll just, like, go down on the ground. It's, I don't know, it's kinda weird how this thing works, but see, we both shoot, skip the cutscene, and then he's getting hit by the rockets and he's dead. So yeah, we should have 348. Yep. And like I said, the record's 347, so, I mean, you know, not bad. Not bad. And the reason they have a 347 is actually weird. The 347 is, like, almost not legit. Reason being is because they had, like, some Xbox Live delay or lag somewhere or something. And they were going to push that dumpster right before Bat Lago. And for some reason, they were able to get, like, a 2-push dumpster instead of a, 4-push dumpster. So, you know, normally we have to push it 4 times, like, like, you know, Shevin and Chris are, like, pushing it all, struggling to push it 4 times. For some reason, they pushed it, and it was just 2. It was just like, boom, boom, done. And they were like, what? And then they just went with it. So, like, their run up before that time was not, like, spectacular. I mean, it was good. It was solid, but it wasn't, like, you know, really, really good. And then they got that, and that's what saved the time. So it was like, what? So that's why we think we can get, you know, the 346 on it. Now, this chapter is actually by far the hardest chapter to do. Like, for normal, anyways. For this particular segment around that we were doing. And it's not even that it's, like, quote-unquote hard as in, you know, it takes a lot of skill. It's just hard because you're basically praying for RNG. Like, that's it. And it's just, you can't do anything about it. So it's really difficult to just sit there and grind, you know, until you get it. And then, like, you may not get, like, the perfect Gigante or Indesu fight, and, you know, it's like, oh, man, we, like, lost, you know, 2 seconds, and, like, now we have to do this again, but on normal, oh, my gosh, it's so hard. So, for me, and I tried this with several different people. I tried this with JC, as you can see here, JCStrickland. I tried it with, I want to say I tried it with Snow maybe like a couple times, but like we didn't go like super hardcore with it. He already had a time, so like he didn't really need it. And then I tried a lot with the Carpenter. So just from me, and you know, this was just for me to completely finish my seg run. I wanted to get this one done because this is the only chapter I didn't have done. This is the only chapter I didn't have a seg time for. I had a 2-cycle Indesu, and I didn't have the 1-cycle. So I needed to get this done, and I was like, oh man, I really don't want to have to do this, but this is the only chapter I need. I might as well just do it. So this was in August 7th. This is a whole, you know, it's what, 2 months after, you know, everything else had been done. Like, we had quit playing. We were just like, all right, we're done. And I was like, alright, you know what, let's just try and get this done. So I tried with Carp, and then I did this one day with JC. In total, it took me 13 plus hours. Like I don't know the exact amount, but it was over 13 hours, for sure, to get this one run. And it wasn't even good. It was just a 1-cycle, and I was just like, done, like... I got the 1-cycle, I'm done, that's it. But it took me over 13 hours to get just this one segment done, literally. And I got it, wasn't even good. And I was just like, you know what, screw it, man. Like, I got the 1-cycle, that's all I need. That's all I wanted, you know? So it's a horrible time. This one's horrible, and like, I could save a lot of time on it, but I'm never doing this on normal again, man. Because after 13 hours of this, like, small chapter, like, think about it. Like, we sit there and we would just reset Indesu for hours. Literally hours. Just on him. Like, you know, we get through this part and it takes, like, you know, a few minutes. We get to Indesu and we would just sit there and reset for hours upon hours upon hours. Just, like, waiting for him to give us the one cycle. Like, we do everything perfect and just waiting for RNG. Like, ugh. It was so horrible. But me and JC ended up playing for, like, 30 minutes. Oh, and by the way, we get the weird truck glitch here. You, like, watch my screen, and, like, my truck is, like, freaking out. It's, like, moving the entire time. Like, it's still getting hit. Like, I hate when that happens. But, you know, it's one of those things. So we end up getting a horrible time. The record, which is what Snow and Outrage have for this chapter for Xbox, on normal, is a 425. Now, the fastest time is a 422, but that's on amateur. I believe it's by Resi Runner, but let me check. And I will tell you. Yes. No. This is the wrong one. It is by Matrix. So, Matrix and Mr. Scarface have the 422, and that is, from what I know, the fastest time for a 1-cycle for console. I don't know about Steam. Steam might be faster just because it's a faster platform, but as you can see here, we finally get the 1-cycle, and we're like, hooray! And we were like, oh my gosh, it actually happened. Second team ever to do it. Like, yes. Like, we were so happy. On normal, man, it's not fun. So, yeah, Snow could save, you know, possible 3 seconds just because, you know, Matrix and Scarface have the 422. He has a 425. We end up getting a 431, which is, you know, a really bad time. I mean, we could save, what is that, like, 9 seconds? So, ugh. It's gross, but it's a one cycle, and it's the second one to ever happen on normal, so we're going to take it. So now we're moving on to Chapter 3-1. And Chapter 3-1 is actually one of the top three hardest chapters, like, skill-wise. I would say the hardest chapters skill-wise. This is probably number two. I don't know. Like, it's hard to tell. It's going to be, like, the later chapters, obviously, that are, like, the hardest. But this is, like, number two, in my opinion, the second hardest. Number one hardest is for sure 5-3 in terms of skill. And as you can see, like, I don't have Snow's side, and I'm playing as Chris here. This is the only chapter I actually play as Chris. But the reason I don't have Snow's is because he doesn't have a faster time. This is actually his PB. But we thought we had a really good run on this run, and we were still 4 seconds behind Resi Runner's time, and he got so mad that he just kind of rage quit and deleted his video, even though I told him to keep it since it was still his PB. But, you know, we've decided that we don't want to try and do this level again on Xbox Live. We're gonna, you know, wait to play it on LAN if we ever do play again. So we end up getting, you know, a 529, and Resi Runner's time is a 525, so, you know, 4 seconds. But it's still the fastest time overall, I believe. I don't know what Comchick has, and I'm not gonna refer to any of Comchick's times just because it's, there's no point. Like, he's playing on 60, and there's no point in, like, comparing at all, because his is faster, and he may, you know, he may have a comparable time, but he's not playing as good as, you know, you could. You should have way faster times on Steam, you know. So yeah. This part right here is probably by far the hardest part to get. Trying to shoot this, and I don't even get it perfect here. This is like a above average one, I guess you could say. Like, I get it kind of quick, but had we had a better angle for me to see it, like, sooner, it would have been better. We lose a good, like, second, I believe, to Resi Runner just on this particular section right here. Snow's a really good driver, though. Snow is, like, super good at driving this boat, so props to him on this, for sure. It's hard to drive this boat, and that's one reason I say it's the second hardest. You know, not only do you have to drive this boat, like, really well, but the other person's got to be good, like, at all the other stuff. So this swamp area, there's not really anything special. He kills the crocs for me, so that I don't have to deal with him at all. He just kind of goes with him. You can see on the map at the top right there, he's following me. He just busts the crocs, so I don't even have to look at him. But yeah, I don't know. This chapter, it was a solid run. I mean, we went back and, like, put them side by side, ours and Resi Runners, and we know where we lost time, but it's so difficult to get a good run on this, and it's mainly just because of the boat. That's the only reason. Like, everything else we're good at, we're fine, you know, it's just the boat. You lose so much time if you mess up steering it and stuff. So he shoots me through the checkpoint there, you know. Use the proxies. You saw me do that earlier to him. We actually do another, we actually do two more in this chapter. We do a lot of them here. So he's gonna shoot me later. I'm going to shoot both of us here in a second on this next island. But yeah, I've pretty much, you know, gone through the majority of, you know, what I want to say in terms of, like, times and, you know, why we did this and such. So at this point, you know, I may not talk quite as much. And you can see Snow's, like, pointing out to me, like, exactly where he wants me to shoot. I'm like, all right, dude, I got you. I got you, man. Because I'm pretty sure this is our first time to do this. Oh, maybe in second. Maybe in, like, second. But either way, his best time before this, I know, was, like, a 5:30 flat? 5:31, maybe? Like, I know him and Carpenter did one. They had, like, a 5:31, I believe. We ended up getting 529, but we thought we had at least, like, you know, a 527. So we were pretty disappointed whenever it showed the final result screen. We're like, what? But then whenever we watched them side by side, we understood why we lost it. We were just, like, so mad. Like, and it was, like, it was so hard to comprehend because, I mean, I don't know. It was all boat mechanics, basically. But you can see I shoot us through that checkpoint. But like I said, I'm going to try and, you know, talk about, like, main points here and there and, like, things that are coming up. But I probably won't be talking quite as much now that I've pretty much covered, you know, all the bases of why we did this run, what this run is, etc., etc. So, yeah. This turn right here is actually extremely difficult. He made it look super buttery smooth. This game is actually really, really fun. It's, in terms of speedrunning, it's my number one, like, speedrun game at the moment for the games that I do. It's just so much fun to play co-op, and the strats you come up with and stuff, it's just, I don't know, man, like, the way it feels and the memes we have with it, I don't know, it's really, really fun. So he's going to shoot me through this checkpoint coming up. And if there was something in a previous chapter that I didn't cover, you know, I'm sorry. Some of it is basically pretty trivial. In a lot of the first chapters, there's not a lot of, like, super advanced tech, I guess, to cover. It's mainly just, you know, you do stuff. And you see me, I say come on there. That actually aggroes those guys a little bit for him to get past easier, because I can't kill any of them. If I kill any people in this area, it actually ruins this whole thing. We have to, like, start over. So the reason I don't kill them is because, bam, those guys open the door. And that's way faster than me opening the door. So that's why I can't kill anyone. If I kill anyone, they don't spawn and they don't open that door for me. So you can see there, I did a double grenade turn. If you just do the normal turnaround, it's slower. And I could have, like, locked onto Snow and done it, like, and done the quick turn, the 180 that way, but there's a potential to mess that up on that particular spot. I don't know. It's kind of weird. But yeah, 529. It's a good time, but it's not, you know, not the best. So now we're starting 3-2. And this is the one that I really wanted to talk about. So when we first started, I want to say Snow's time was like a 6:20, 6:18. I don't know. I don't know if it may have been even higher. 'Cause he had did this with CryingWolf, and you know, they had a good time. It was like, you know, in between. It was in between like 6:18 to 6:30, somewhere in there. But we actually end up getting a 6:08. We get a 6:08, but I disconnect on the very last cutscene. I'm talking like the entire place is blowing up, and all we got to do is like skip it. And I can't skip it. And I'm like, why can't I skip it? And then I just disconnect. And it's like, sorry, you've been kicked out of the whatever. I was like, no. So, you know, Snow didn't get kicked. So obviously he gets the 6:08, but it doesn't count it for me. And I'm like, no, what? So I end up just having to settle with a 6:09. That's the time that I got, like, you know, whatever. But the reason we got so much lower than what he had was because I actually figured out, like, I sat down and started studying, like, film. You know, I started being the coach, like, watching film and, like, putting them side by side in Vegas, you know, editor, and looking at them and figuring out times and, like, okay, you know, we need to be at this point in this many seconds and whatever. And we actually make a mistake right here that we didn't even think about. Okay, so watch this. See how we skipped that cutscene? We shouldn't have done that. Reason being, Snow's actually hitting the bridge. Had we just waited because cutscenes don't count for time, we would have saved like half a second. But anyways, I started timing it, and like as we were doing runs, like as soon as I would jump down, I had a live split open, had a foot pedal, and you know, I would jump down at a certain point, start it, and then if we weren't getting to me getting on that ladder off the raft at a certain time, we would just reset like the whole thing, because we know exactly what time we need to get for the best time. And if like his crank wasn't good, or like it ate inputs or something like that, and I wasn't getting there at the certain amount of time, I think it was like a minute 19 or something like that, I can't remember, I have it written down somewhere, I can find it. But if we didn't have that time, we just reset straight up. And you can see it took like a second for that to load. Like, that was Xbox Live acting stupid right there. We were like, what the heck? So that's, like, a good, like, second, you know, that we could save. We have written down that we could probably save 3 seconds in total off of our time. So we're thinking 6:05 is the best possible 3:02 you could get on 360. Normal, too, you know what I mean? Like, I don't know if it's any different if you can get a faster time on amateur with certain things, but... Oh, and the reason, you know what, here we go. Here's a good story. Alright, so I take these flames on purpose. Reason being, I can run up against them after I've hit them. And then I'm closer. And actually, I'm gonna wait to tell my story here in a second. But, I kill those guys. Me and Snow have another timer here. Where we're like, okay, you need to be on your crank at a certain point, Snow. And, you know, if you're not there, then we need to reset. And I've got to kill my chainsaw guy, like, as quick as possible, right after Snow's gotten his. So, right here. So we get the checkpoint by killing that chainsaw guy below me. And then we're able to move through. But... you know, we could do the fire glitch here and save like a good minute or more, but like I said, this is glitchless. We're planning on maybe doing a glitched run in the future just to see what kind of crazy time we could get. We probably won't use the pausing glitch or any of that stuff, but this room right here, this is the room where we saved so much time. Like, I studied and studied and studied. I don't remember whose run it was, and you can see I turn on subtitles on purpose for this part, and I'll show you why. So, we figured out where to shoot, to both just shoot one rocket to kill everyone in the room. So I don't have Snow's side for this particular run, but I do have his others. Like, I think I have his time for 6:10. But anyways, I have a timer going throughout this entire room. And when Josh said, nice job, but don't let your guard down. If he doesn't say that at a certain time, we restart. But the most important part is, we have certain parts we're shooting at in this room. And if he doesn't say almost got it at a certain second, right there. If he doesn't say almost got it at a certain time, we reset. And that is the biggest difference. That was what shaved off like tens of 20 of seconds. Like for some reason, that right there costs so much time if you like wait for him. If he says it late. And he says it late a lot. Like it took us a long time to get him to do that. And the whole reason I turn on subtitles is so I can see him saying it. We're shooting so many rockets, it's so loud that I literally can't hear him say anything. So I'm like, yo, let me turn on subtitles because I'm not going to know when he's saying this. So I was like, all right. But I have my timer going, and as soon as he says it, I'm like, okay, we're good, or we're not, you know. And then I'm like, just keep firing, keep firing, keep firing. And then I had a timer where I was like, okay, let's stop, let's go to the elevator. Because I know how long it takes him to, like, you know, after he's said, almost got it, I know how long it'll take him. And there's another part in here we timed too. Like there was a lot of different times we had to have in order for this to work, and we had to time a lot of different sections. So this time we had to have him get to this control panel at a certain time, and actually say his words right there. And if he didn't say it at a certain time, we would reset, and then we would watch that cutscene. And as soon as that cutscene came up, we would look at the timer, and if the timer was good, then we were good. And then we would just kill all the guys in here. But anyways, yeah, we had, like, that weird load. This isn't our 608, though, so, I mean, like, you know, obviously, it's... You know, this one's got some flaws in it. The 608 was better, obviously, but this one is still really solid. So anyways, the reason I was going to say, the reason we had to play this on normal, you may be asking. So, obviously, for SEG, you want to play on amateur. Because, I mean, it's going to be the fastest. However, we could not do that. Reason was, Snow back in the day, you know, I mean, he's been playing RE5. He's an RE5 OG. Like, he's been playing this game and been a runner of it since... Basically, it came out, and he was with the old school guys of, you know, Bronin and Rezzy and Matrix and all those other guys. So, we would have loved to put on amateur. However, there was some random kid back in the day. That's literally what Snow said. Some random kid. We don't even know who it was. I don't. He does. And this random kid played with Snow one time. Snow invited him. And he used, like, glitched weapons and glitched some other stuff. And actually messed up Snow's amateur time. Like, he got a time that's not actually possible without cheating. And messed up his amateur time. So we couldn't use it anymore. And this was a long time ago. And Snow actually gets hit right there. That was another reason we got 609 on this one. He's not, like, super far behind, but... I don't want to be kicking this because it's slower due to Xbox Live and me not being host. We want him to kick it and me, you know, get kicked through. But and then I had a bad turn right there. But oh, and I also get stuck right here. Love it. We want to be at that timer at 131. We got there at 130, so that's a second. And we get the 609. But 608 is the actual record, and that's what I have. You know, that's why I say I have a 110. 28 instead of 29, but we're gonna call it 110-29 just to be legit about it. But yeah, some kid messed up Snow's amateur time and basically made it to where it was a cheating time, so we couldn't use amateur anymore. We had to do normal. It's unfortunate, but you know. 3-3 is on rails. We believe... Well, see, we right now we have it wrote down that we can't save any time on it. We've tried a bunch of times, but... I don't know. I mean, you might be able to save it the second. And, you know, RE5 actually goes by milliseconds. It truly does go by milliseconds. It's not just full seconds. So, there's been times where me and Snow have done a run. we may get the same time. Like, for example, let's say we do this run. Our time on this, and I don't have sound on this one, by the way, also. And I don't have his side because he has another one with CryingWolf that he did before he did it with me. So he's like, I don't need this one. I already have one. I'm like, all right. But either way, say we do this and we get our 339, right? So say we do another run. And, you know, his say his overall time is, a you know, 1:10:20 on, like, the leaderboard thing. We get another 339. He goes back and checks. And now he has a 1:10:19. And we're like, wait, what? What? You got the same time, though. That's actually happened a couple different times on a couple different chapters. Where we've gotten a time that we've gotten before. But our milliseconds were better. So say we had, like, you know, a 339 and like 30 milliseconds or whatever, 0.3. And say we go do another 339, we get 339.1. So we saved 0.2 milliseconds, and those 0.2 milliseconds are added, you know, or subtracted to our total time. And our total time only needed, you know, 0.1 or 0.2 to go down a whole second for it to say the second below it. And so we're like, oh, sweet. We, like, shaved a second off, even though we actually didn't, you know. So, yeah, this game actually does go by milliseconds, believe it or not. So, you know, don't ever think that just because you got the same time that you can't save time, because you can still save time. And that's actually happened a couple different times to us. So, you know, even though we get, like, the same time here as him and CryingWolf, you know, we're like, well, maybe we still save us, you know, a little bit of time. You don't ever know. So, and it may not show it, may not be a full second, but, like, you never know. Like, so it's just always, you know, like, keep pushing and keep going for it, so. But at the end of this chapter, we actually get a quick kill. You know, we got a quick kill on Batlago on Papa Karimu. We get a quick kill on Irving on this chapter. And you can see, like, there, I get on the Switch, it takes a second, that's Xbox Live. See, if we were on LAN, it'd be quicker. There's just certain things, like, we could get a 338 on LAN, for sure, just because, you know, climbing up stuff, activating things, all be faster, jumping over stuff, all that would be quicker. So, it's unfortunate that, like, you know, people around the world, like, you know, all these good players can't play together on LAN. That would be the ideal situation. And if you ever do get the chance and you have someone, a co-op partner that you get to play on LAN with, just be grateful, because that's a blessing in disguise right there. Get to play with, like, your brother or your cousin or your friend down the street or something like that, right? It's like, yeah, that's amazing. So anyways, we get the quick kill here on Irving. Me and Snow actually have two different ways of doing it. Me and the Carpenter are actually New Game Plus partners. Well, me and Snow are new game partners. Me and the Carpenter figured out, like, a different way of doing this. Where we stand up front. And I think, is he going to do it too? Yeah, okay, he does it on this one. I think I told him to try it. And we end up getting it. Normally there's a cutscene of him coming up. But we shoot him during the cutscene and it kills him. But normally, you know, Snow used to stand in the back and shoot from way far away. But I guess now he does what we do. Or maybe he just did it for me. How sweet. But yeah, 339. And we right now we have marked down that we don't think we can save any time. But, you know, obviously if we were on land, we could probably get a 338. All right. We are moving into my number one favorite chapter. The reason it's my favorite is just because of the feel, the aesthetics of it. Like, I mean, it's kind of fun to play. It's not, like, super, like, riveting fun, you know, or something. But, I mean, I don't know, just something about it. The atmosphere of it, I love it. But, me and Snow, we think we can still save 2 seconds on this one, like, for sure. There's a couple instances that we can save some time on. It's just really hard because it's all RNG due to this one part where you gotta wait for these like flaming balls to come and give you a good pattern, basically. And you'll see that later, but we actually have a really cool strat here that I'll walk us through. So when we start here, you don't want a quick turn, you just want a like regular turn. And right now we're just like messing around waiting for the checkpoint. Like we're gonna reset it, but you just want to run to the left. Don't want a quick turn or anything, that takes time. Running's faster. And curving. So what's gonna happen is I'm gonna hit him with a grenade into the checkpoint.
Okay. I hope Irving was telling the truth when he said we'd find answers in this place.
So I aim at a certain point. Wait for his triangle to appear on my map. At a certain point. Chunker grenade. And blast him into the checkpoint. It's pretty slick, actually. It's like, I'm throwing that grenade pretty far. Pretty far down there. To hit him, so. Somehow that one counted, like I was barely on that trigger. You could see it was like a little wonky, but... And then I just try and kill these guys so they don't mess with snow. And then this part. This is the area of no return. So once you get past this part coming up, there's a checkpoint and like it's the point of no return. And this is where it gets hectic. This is where we can save our 2 seconds. So as you can see, I've got a proxy. I'm going to place this in a certain spot. And hope it kills everyone. Snow gets on that at a certain time, so that by the time I get on it, it immediately starts. Because if you wait, and if you do it both at the same time, it takes longer. But if you have someone to where they're just about, like you press B and their animation is just about to finish, then it's actually quicker, right as soon as I get on. Hurry! So we had pretty good RNG there, but we could still be quicker. Who's gonna shoot me through? And it's funny because Sheva immediately stands up. I love that. She's like, ah, whoop. He immediately stands up. I love that animation. And on this part, we don't know for sure. I mean, it's a cutscene, so we, you know, we're thinking it doesn't count for time, but you want Sheva to fall down. Like that. It is a little quicker, we think. Like, we've put them side by side, and it might be like a smidge quicker. I don't know. Just like watching that. But it's a cutscene, so it shouldn't count for time. But we always try and go for it anyways. There's a way to do it where the Sheva player just doesn't jump over quite as quick. Like Chris presses it immediately, but Sheva like waits a second and then does it. And you know, okay. If she's late and he's, you know, quick on the draw, then you should be good and she'll be the one that'll fall down. But yeah, this time we end up getting a 534, and that is the current record. We can still save probably 2 seconds, we think. Resi Runner has a 536, so we're 2 seconds faster than him on this. Which is pretty good. Him and Captain Blubber. And Captain Blubber I believe, is Charlie. And Charlie is Snow's... Well, let me think about that. I think he is... It's either Resi Runner... It's one of these two. It's either Captain Blubber or Resi Runner. I don't remember which. One of them's Charlie, and Charlie is Snow's apprentice from back in the day. So, you know, one his apprentice was beating his time for a long time until we decided that, yeah, let's change that. So this part is pretty self-explanatory. Like, there's nothing special at this point of 4-1. You just go pull levers, and that's pretty much it. So I'm just going to let it kind of, like, play out and start talking about 4-2 whenever it starts up.
Hurry up!
Okay. Come on! Thanks. Okay.
Chris!
Okay.
This is another one that I don't have Snow's side of. And I think it's because we tied what him and Outrage or him and CryingWolf had, so he didn't need it. But this one has some pretty cool tricks to it. So we start out here. And I bust that one, and he busts the other one. So, that was his, it was the second one, the first one was mine, I believe, and that gets rid of the lasers completely. So then you don't have to worry about him, he gets that emblem right before I'm about to get that checkpoint. And as long as he gets it right before I get it, then we can reset the checkpoint and we'll still have it. So he's got to be quick on his feet, like he has to... shoot that rocket and then turn around and go real quick without getting hit and grab that emblem. So he threw me over. As soon as he throws me over, he's got to hurry and turn around, and if he... Alright, so we're basically just using checkpoints to meet up. You know, like that way both characters are in the same spot. That way you don't have to run to each other, which is way quicker. These guys, you can actually, like, slip through, but it's extremely hard, and it was just safer to do that. And I was able to get that right before you get the checkpoint, so it all worked out. And now we've got all the pieces, so now we can just, you know, reset and put all the pieces in and continue on. And on this chapter, we end up getting a 238, but Resi Runner has a 236 on his PS3. So we know for sure we can save at least 2 seconds, but we think 3 is something we could do. So, you know, we could get a 235 potentially on this one. But we felt this was another one that we wanted to just try to do, you know, on land. Reason being is there's so many of these mirrors, and these mirrors, like, have a delay, you know, obviously whenever you're trying to get on them for whoever's not host. And it can make it a little difficult. But there's actually a pretty cool trick coming up right here. Snow's actually going to use the nitrogen round to freeze himself. He can't use a flash round because he has glasses on Chris. But he stuns himself with it as I move the laser over. The laser goes through him, but because he's in iframes, it doesn't hurt him. It doesn't kill him. So that's a quick way to get through that part. And then we always reset these. But you'll see what I'm talking about when it comes to the mirrors. Like, it'll take a second for me to get on. And if you watch, like, as soon as I'm going to click, like, right there, it was a little slow to click kick that, but that's okay. And then to, like, get on and get off the mirrors, it, like, takes a second for some reason. It's really strange. And if we touch any of the lasers, we immediately die. So you gotta be really careful in this area. You just gotta, you know, make sure you don't hit anything. So I fast-forwarded this part, I remember. reason was because we were talking about there's a few different strats you can do in here. And, like, depending on where you want, you know, the Sheva player to go or the Chris player to go. And we had to talk it over. And it's like, which one do you want to do? What are we doing here? What's the best way? And he's like, oh, let's try this. And he started throwing grenades and showing me. But now we're actually doing it, so. So I need to run forward a little bit but not get hit. Like that. And then he's going to proceed to hit me through the checkpoint. I believe he hits me. I don't think I hit him. I don't remember that, so. But maybe I do hit him. I don't know. We'll see. Nah, he's going to hit me. So he hits me with the rocket just because the rocket has a bigger blast radius and, like, should potentially send me further forward. So we know that it's at the end of the chapter, so we don't have to heal. And, if, you know, obviously if you used it in another part of the chapter, it had to heal, it would be slower. So that's why we normally use grenade launcher, but we're able to use rocket there. So now we are in 5-1. And this is also another one of our first attempts. You know, our 3... no, I'm sorry. Our 2-1 was a first try. Well, this one, I believe, was also a first try. So, it was pretty good, and we end up getting the record on this one. It's 221. And Resi Runner has a 222. So, yeah. And we don't think we can save any more time on this one. We think this one is actually dead. There's a couple different chapters. There's maybe, like, 3 chapters that we consider dead, unless you play on land. So, this is one. 1-1 is one. 6-2 and 6-3. We believe all those are dead. But the rest of them you can still save time on. So you can see he kicked me through the door, you know. Just saving time here and there. So I gotta turn around and shoot this rocket real quick. And what that does is bust open the glass right there so he doesn't have to. And then I just gotta worry about the liquors. And then he is going to shoot me through this checkpoint. Which, that angle's really hard to get. You gotta be real precise on that, because otherwise you'll hit the wall or you'll go too far forward and then you can't get the angle to hit Sheva that you want, because she's gotta be at the base of the stairs. So that one's pretty tricky.
Come on.
Okay.
I don't think they'll notice us.
Ooh, that door. That was a really nice door kick. So I go to the outside because I know Sheva's going to be on the right. Like, it just moves Sheva to the right no matter what. So I move all the way to the left because I know, you know, I was ahead of Chris. And I don't want to get in his way whenever we get to the door. If I'm standing on the right, you know, he's not going to be able to get to it. He's going to have to go around me. So I just go all the way to the left and then we just kind of warp whenever we hit B. That's like the one elevator in the game right there that you can hit B immediately going into. All the other elevators, like the door opens, you get on, and then you have to kind of wait a second. But for some reason, that one you can just walk into and press B, and it works. Now, this took us forever to get right here. Him shooting me into this. That angle is so hard. Sheva has to run at such a precise angle, it's ridiculous, like, how hard that was. It didn't seem like it was that bad, but man, it took us forever to get it. Yeah, I was like, hurry and restart, please, hurry and restart before we die. So we elected to start with the grenade. Reason being, going quick shot from grenade to rocket is faster than doing quick shot from gun to rocket, so we elected to use the grenade instead of the Rafika. And we end up getting the 221. So 5-2 is one of the harder ones as well. I would say maybe third or fourth hardest. So this was the facility accepted. With like 6-2 being the 3 or 4, depending on which one it isn't. but yeah, this one's pretty hard. We end up getting a 442, and I believe it says that the record is a 441. I don't believe we have an actual video or a reference of who it is. It may have been Resi Runner, but he just doesn't have the video anymore or something, but either way. So we want those guys to leave that door open so we can run through. A lot of this is just like praying, like this part right here, especially, like running through these guys. And getting through without getting hit, not fun. And you can see we got bumped a lot, like, going through, so we could save time there. This part is pretty hard, too, just because there's so many guys at the end here. And, like, you know, you can get shot, but, like, you just don't want to get stunned. If you get shot too many times, you'll get stunned and you'll go to the ground. You'll either A, fall on your back, and that's, like, really bad, or B, you'll go to your knee and then get up. But we can't have either of those things happen. We have to just make it through without getting stunned or any of that. This room is all about good movement. And I believe we get super good RNG in here. Okay, so we want that guy to climb up, so he's not in our way. We also want these other guys to climb up too, but these normally don't ever happen. But we end up to get that guy to do it. We're like, what? And then this guy, you know, it wasn't a problem at all. So we were just able to get through that, like, nothing. Lickety split. We were like, wow, that was such good RNG. I remember us being really happy about that, because that was like our first try too. We were like, what the heck? So in a actual, you know, single segment speedrun, we would do the glitch right there where it makes it to where the guys are just like frozen in the room for some reason. But obviously for Seg, you know, you gotta kind of go balls out. So, you know, we elected not to do that and just go for it, obviously. So, because we're trying to save time and frames. Man, about that slow life. But, you know, out of all the parts of this chapter that are, like, you know, quote-unquote hard, where you have to wait on, like, you know, RNG or guys or whatever else, this next area right here is the worst, by far. This is the worst part. This, conveyor belt is the bane of RE5 speedrunning. It's there's so many problems that can happen. These grenades, these barrels, these guys at the end with the shields, just everything. It's all bad. Like, everything is just bad. But we get through, so we're good to go. And then the rest of this chapter is actually real easy. It's really all just about movement at this point, making sure movement is super crisp, super good. Other than that, I mean, there's not any big tricks. You just kind of got to have really good movement at this point. Taking turns fluidly and not getting caught on anything.
Missiles?
What could they be planning?
I'd say a war.
So I remember, like, I ended up getting caught, like, I hit a dead zone on my, controller, so I was like, oh, no, we gotta restart. We got that checkpoint, so we gotta restart it. And on this part, you gotta aggro this Reaper, make him come down, and then both of you go past him. If you get too far forward, what'll happen is he'll drop down, and he'll drop, like, he doesn't really drop on you, but it acts like it drops on you, and then it stuns you for a second, so you don't want that to happen, because then he has the time to grab you and insta-kill you. So Snow ends up going the other direction on the other conveyor, up against the opposite direction. It's just as quick. I make it past that first box. There's no way for the second person to ever make it past the first box, so you know, that's not an issue. And he had really good movement, so yeah, this chapter was pretty solid. I mean, we're still a second behind, like, you know, console record, but it was really good. So he was just messing around, throwing incendiary on him. We're just waiting for the checkpoint. And that's it for that chapter. So we can obviously save a second on this one, but it was still pretty solid. Alright, 5-3. By far, the hardest chapter. And RE5. In general. But especially for Seg. It's horrible. This is a really hard chapter. What's all this nonsense about? This is what separates the men from the boys. But we get 1 second off console record on this. And we know why. And it's all due to this one room that's RNG. But we found out throughout this whole process that there is an actual difference between the Xbox and the PS3 when it comes to this chapter. And we're probably thinking other chapters too, but for sure this chapter. We thought maybe, you know, it was different because maybe we're playing on normal, or maybe because we were on NTSC, right? Well, come to find out, it's literally just a console difference. PS3 and 360 have a difference when it comes to Wesker. Because at this point, this is one of the chapters we waited till last to do. So you see, we're doing some crazy stuff. Like, Snow shoots a nitrogen round over there. I have to avoid the Reaper. He has to avoid all those guys and the Reaper. Those guys have to hold the door for me. I have to not get a third Reaper to come down. And then he's got to try and get to this console really quick. And he was like half a step not there. But we were like, you know what? That's really good, dude. Like, we're still going. Because this room right here is like the second hardest room. It's definitely the second hardest room. It's so tough. This whole place. So I'm watching here. I have a visual cue on when to pull it. To get like the perfect pull. I have another visual cue that I use. And that gets me another perfect pull, and then he gets a perfect pull too. So, like, we have really good pulls on these. So anyways, this next room right here, though, is the bad part. This is the part where it's literally no return. Like, we have to get through. And we hope they keep the door open, and we hope we don't get it. So, watch Snow screen first. He's gonna come in. He, like, froze him. He's like, oh, you know what, I'll just rocket him. Oh no. Acephalo. He tries to freeze it, does nothing. Neither of us get hit somehow. They don't keep the door open, but I'm able to get through it when he kicks it. So, that kick cost us, like, a second. So, had he not had to kick, we would have had the 718, which is, you know, console record on PS3. So anyways, when it comes to these differences, though, when we're in the Wesker room, we found out that, like, literally, you can't do a strat. You just can't do it if you have Xbox. Because I ended up, at this point, having a PAL console. We waited till I had my PAL console, because we knew it was coming, to do this, because we thought it was a PAL issue. Because we thought maybe that was why it wasn't working for us. And then we find out it's just an Xbox issue. So I literally had to make up a new strat. Just for Xbox. Just for us to be able to do what we were trying to do. So, I have to shoot a rocket in a particular spot to aggro Wesker. And then I have to shoot another rocket that hurts him enough, but not stunning myself. And on the PS3 version, when we would watch Resi Runner, he could do it easy. He would just shoot in this one spot. It would, like, work. I don't know. Like, everything was, like, perfect. We would try it, we couldn't get it to work. At all. Ever. Not once. We tried for hours. Days. Doesn't matter. So I ended up having to try and find a newer way to do it. And I did. And we got it to work. And it's like, that was the only reason we got the time we did. Before this, I want to say Snow's best time was like a high 720 something. You know, like 729 or something like that. And then we started dwindling it down. We got, like, you know, 724, 722. And then we finally get this run, which is the 719. And we were like, we can't do any better unless we're on land and we have maybe, like, you know, I don't know. Like, we were like, we just never want to play this again on 360, like, ever. Like, we'll do it on Steam. But we're never going to do it on this again because we're not dealing with the crap like we had to. But as you can see right here, we're trying to shoot these guys off the lever as quick as possible. And we get them pretty quick on both. They may not have been, like, completely perfect, but, I mean, they were 90% good. Like, pretty good. But, grinding this chapter was the worst thing ever. Like, it took us so long to get this run. I don't know how long it took us. So in this next area, you know, on this area, the whole focus was just get the guys off the livers as quick as possible. The first area that we had before that was we had to freeze those guys, make sure they open the door, don't get a Reaper, get to the console, get good pulls, get to the next room, make sure no one hits us, try and keep them, keep the door open. It was like, you know, there's so many different things, and we lost 1 second in there, but the rest of the stuff we do, like, pretty excellent. So this room right here, I actually figured out. We had, like, a really good run one time, I remember. And, like, you know, at this point, we had, like, a 722 or something like that. We had a super good run, right? We're like, oh, man, we got through without getting hit. They left the door open and everything. And, like, we finish, and we have, like, a 724. And we're like, what? Like, I remember that day, we were so mad. Like, we rage quit. Like, we didn't, like, we just completely got off, like, the internet and everything. It's important to get that emblem right there. Not really, but I pull it through the cutscene like that. Just a meme, guys. Just a meme. But I try and... The hard part is trying to pull the lever at the perfect time when Snow's, like, getting on. Because if you do it too early, like, he won't be able to get on. But anyways, we had that 724. We were just like, oh my gosh. What the heck? And then we found out it's this room. Literally this room. Like, the whole thing with 3-2, how I said we had, like, timers in every single room because we were, like, losing time and we didn't know why. And then we found out that it was, like, certain rooms and that you had to have a certain time, like, with Josh saying something at a certain time and all that. Well, it's basically the exact same thing here. Like, I can't remember exactly. I think it was something with, yeah, it dealt with what Chris is doing right now, the dumpster push. So we had a timer going, and we had to have Snow be done with the dumpster push at a certain amount of time. And if we didn't, then we had to reset. And we didn't find that out until, like, so many runs in and so many, like, finished attempts. And then we were like, wait, what? We're losing time to this room? Because, like, we put two runs next to each other. We put Resi Runners and ours next to each other. And we were like, why are we losing so much time? What is this? And then we find out, because, like, we were, like, you know, keeping up with them up until this room, and then we see this room, and we're like, oh, are you serious? We were so mad. It was, we were so mad, because we were like, this is an easy room, we could have fixed this. But anyways, don't blink on this part, because this part's really fast, but, yeah. this is the part I had to make a new strat for, and then we ended up adapting and making it work. So, I think we host swap. I remember right, because Sheva has to be hosed. Yep, we do. In order for this to work, Sheva has to be the host. So we quit out, get back in, invite him, and yeah, I have a little thing saying, like, you know, I don't have the part of Snow accepting the invite. We had so many different recordings before we actually, like, finished Wesker, that he just deleted all the old ones we didn't need, and that was one of them. That Wesker. On that third rocket, after you shoot that third rocket, if he doesn't leave immediately after getting hit by it, then you have to reset, like, before he gets to the door, because if he takes a second, it's not good. And then we got the Jill strat. And, like, this was a little slow. But not, like, extremely. And I was, like, trying to, like, hit it so fast that I accidentally slipped and hit the big X button. I remember that. I was like, oh, no! But We got it. And we got the 7... Like, we were going for just 720, man. We were just wanted the 720, that's all. And we got 719 where we're just like, we threw our controller, like, spiked our controllers through the ground. We were like, done! Like, done! Never again. Never again. Never, ever. Oh, it was hellacious. It was bad. Alright, now we're moving into chapter 6. Last 3 chapters. We almost there, boys. So we get a 341. And this one is not one that we did a lot of grinding on. Me and Snow maybe did one or two attempts. I know him and Outrage did a few, but like, this isn't one that we really tried to grind. Like, we really did not like running this one, and it was just like, I don't know, it's just not fun to play. So anyways, he had to dodge that guy, which he used to get hit by him, like, in a lot of attempts. You know, we reset a lot because of that. Anyways, I climb up here. I gotta kill this guy. I gotta snipe out this guy. And then aim at a certain point. And shoot that, and it'll open up that cart right there. That cart of whatever, like. I don't know how that, like, it's crazy. That strat is so fun. Like, that's the best part of this whole chapter right there, is just doing the longbow strat to open up that thing. Like, Sterling with the shout-out right there. Good job, Sterling. I saw, like, Resi someone earlier. Like, good job, guys. Okay. But yeah, that's, that longbow shot is pretty hard, because not only do you have to aim at a certain point, but, like, the longbow just kind of does what it wants. Like, the arrow just kind of goes where it wants to, almost, so it's pretty hard to get it just right. And, like, that dumpster, you can't stop pushing. You have to just keep pushing it all the way. Like, if we could stop, we would. All right, so this grenade throw, I have to time this pretty well. Blows him through the checkpoint. And, like, on this one, I don't think we're not, like, real certain. Oh, this is one. This is another 360 to PS3 difference. So you see how I, like, shot that fat dude and then kicked him? There was no other way to do it. Literally. And we don't know if it was maybe because we were on normal, but, like, literally, there was no other way. Oh, no, I remember, because it wasn't the normal thing. It was, like, you watch Resi Runners, and they do that. He gets on there, and he's able to shoot, you know, the side and, like, not get stunned. Or not get the cutscene to make him stop moving. And I remember Snow, like, cut right here, cut recording, and then he had to, like, we were swapping host, I remember. Anyways. So yeah, he wouldn't get, like, the cutscene. Like, it just wouldn't happen. We were like, what? And we're like, oh, you know, this is back before we had PAL. Like, maybe it's PAL. Maybe it's, like, you know, normal or something. Nope. Because we try it. We get my PAL console, and then it still does it. So we're like, okay, this is another PS3 difference. This has to be. So, like, I end up having to figure out a way to, like, get it to where I could still shoot Snow's thing, his button on that side, and not get, you know, completely wasted by that cutscene. So it was, like, extremely hard to figure out. We're like, what the heck do we do, man? But I ended up finding a strat, and, you know, obviously it's a little slower, and that's why, you know, we lose, like, 2 seconds overall to Resi Runners, just, like, because of that. And we don't really know why. I don't think there's any other, like, particular reason why on the other stuff, but I don't know. This chapter was just not one that we tried to grind a lot, and we were just like, eh, whatever, we have a decent time. Like, it's cool. So you can see Snow's checking out the computer. That's really important. You gotta read the document. If you don't, the run just, you know, it just won't work. Like, you just can't finish the run. It's really strange. You know, you gotta break that, those flower arrangements, containers and stuff. There's a unique set of things you gotta do in this chapter for it to actually end. It's really crazy, so. Just kidding. Just memeing it up. Alright, so we get the checkpoint. That way he can spawn next to me. We won't have to worry about him, like, climbing up the ladder and stuff. So then we just wait. And then we go for it. So the timing of that rocket is actually really hard. Like, Snow gets it really well. There's a lot of tricks that he does that are crazy. Like that one. And then there's a one in 6-3. Where he shoots the JJs. And that one's like threading. It's crazy. So yeah, 339 is the console record on PS3, but this is Xbox record. So we can still save 2 seconds, but you know. Alright, this one. You can see we have 156 on normal there. We'd attempted it once, me and Snow, and we got 156, which is what him and the Carpenter also got. And that was his record for the longest time. He wanted to get 55. And the reason being was because that's what Resi Runner has. He has a 155. So he's like, you know, obviously it's got to be possible. And we're only, you know, 1 second off, so we got to get it. And we're like, all right, man. And this one's pretty technical. This chapter is pretty technical. So I remember Snow hadn't started recording yet, so that's why it's black up there. But you'll see it in a second. So we did one attempt, we got a 156. We're like, okay, because that was just my first time to ever even attempt these segmented strats. It was like really, you know, crazy. They're really technical and stuff. I was like, oh, okay, this is kind of crazy. But we got 156. We're like, sweet. So this is literally our second attempt. Literally second attempt right here. And we end up beating Resi's time. We get a 154. Which Snow didn't even think was possible. He thought 155 was, like, it. Like, he thought that was the fastest you could get. Our second try, we get 154. And we believe that this chapter is now dead, unless you play on land. Like, it is completely at its max now. Once we get inside, this is where it gets, like, pretty technical. You gotta shoot in, like, really precise spots, and I'll try and point out as it goes, but it's really fast. So we're gonna walk in, and we've gotta shoot, like, the tentacles so they'll go away. You'll see. It's, and you gotta not get hit by it, you gotta not get stunned. It's pretty tough. So I remember Snow had stopped his recording just so we could start a fresh one, because you do so many attempts on one section, the file just starts to become, like, huge, you know?
Persistent son of a bitch.
So now what?
So here we go.
Persistent son of a bitch.
So I gotta shoot. This hits this tentacle behind. That one right there, it's gone now. He shoots one, it hits that tentacle, so it's gone. And then this last shot is like the hardest one. Because what you hit is the tentacle upstairs. So where Snow just went, it's gone now. And it also kills that guy who has the keycard. And that shot is super hard to get. So, the next and last part of this chapter is really short. All we gotta do is just get a quick kill on Excella. And I remember, yeah, we switched hosts. And, like, there's been some people that have said that swapping hosts actually loses time. So, I mean, we may be losing time. We don't know. So our times could be even potentially faster. And that's why we want to do it on LAN. It's just because both people are host at that point. There is no host, you know? But we think it's better. And the reason we switched here is because we think if Chris is host, it actually, like, there's something with the shot. Like, I don't know. We don't know exactly, but it seems to be when Chris is the host, it works better. We don't know why. It may just be a placebo. It may just be in our head, but who knows. Yeah, we get 154 and we were like, what the heck? We kind of freaked out a little bit on that one, I remember. And here it is, the last chapter. Chapter 6-3. This one we attempted one time. One time only. And got the record for it. So, let's see. Resi Runner had a 356. And if I remember correctly, Snow, before I started playing with him on this, I think it was with Outrage, had a 358. So he was 2 seconds behind Resi Runner. We do this one time. This is our one and only attempt at it. And we get a 355. And I remember, you know, we posted it on Snow's channel, and he said that Resi Runner had saw the time we got, and he was like, there's no way you guys got that. That's impossible. He was like, that's a magnificent time, dude. And we're like, thanks. But, yeah, this one was really good. But Resi was like, wow, dude, how did you get that? So I shoot that guy for Snow. Shoot these other guys for him as well. Just so he has a clear path, because basically you're just trying to get to that lever as quick as possible. And we don't watch, or we don't skip the cutscenes, we watch them. The reason we watch these cutscenes for sure is because that is actually moving in real time. So that door, had we skipped it as soon as possible, like, we're actually losing time. So if you actually watch it go through, it's moving still in real time. And we're not getting hit or any of that, and the cutscenes don't count for time. So it's opened up more than if we skipped it. Snow keeps getting destroyed. And the most important part about this area is just jumping over as quick as possible and then getting to your button without any movement mishaps. So we're just waiting and then hoping no guys come up behind us.
Come on.
and see, that could have been pulled faster. Had we been on land, of course, and then we watch this one so that it opens up more in real time. Make sure to kill these Reapers because they have insta-kills, and we don't want that. So there's a lot of waiting in this chapter. You just kind of got to wait on these gates. But here's the shot that I was talking about with Snow. With the JJs. It's a pretty cool shot because it's like going through the cutscene. It's like, I don't know how to describe it. You'll see it. You got to have really good timing for this. So see how it was like still, it was like just about to fire as soon as the cutscene ended, and then like it went as soon as the cutscene was over. Because what'll happen, you normally, is like you're shooting and then like your gun will just be, it'll go back up, so you'd have to like pull it back out and then re-aim and shoot. But he got it just on the right time where it fires. And then we get the quick Wesker, which is kind of crazy. Wasn't the quickest Wesker ever, but it's pretty good. And right now we're just running around because like we always reset checkpoint before we actually attempt anything. Oh, we actually switch hosts. Oh yeah, we do switch hosts. I remember now. Okay, yeah. I remember now. Reason being is because the Chris player has to shoot Wesker at a certain point, and the Sheva player's got to shoot him with the rocket. And in order for him to actually get hurt, I have to be the host. If you're not the host, the rocket doesn't work. That was a fast Wesker, boy. That was a nice and radar. There's so many memes about that part right there. So many memes. Here's the last section. So we get another quick kill on him. With the rocket, gotta shoot his shoulder at a certain point, but we have to make sure that Chris does something to manipulate Wesker, into which I can shoot him. So he's gonna shoot me through this checkpoint. First and foremost. And then we're going to reset so we can have the grenades out to run with. And you have to like pull the grenade out first and then reset checkpoint to actually have them out. And then I get my rocket ready. And then we're ready to go.
Why can't you understand, Chris?
So Chris has to jump up there, turn around real fast, and get down. And I shoot him. In the left shoulder. And it kills him. And then we just spam L and R as fast as we can.
Locked in
So Snow's time was a 358. Rezzy's was a 356. And we get 355. So we think that one's pretty much dead. But you never know. Just like Ocarina of Time was dead, right? Yeah. So then here at the end, I kind of show you, you know, the leaderboard for 360 just to show you where we place and, you know, I'm showing that I'm actually on the Xbox. You can see here, this is the Xbox, you know, menu. And then I show my all my different times. So we're looking at normal. So 819, 252... 330, and you can see the total down there at the very bottom, 110.29. But I actually have a 110.28. The game just didn't want me to have it. So, you know, that's fine, whatever. But my biggest time save would definitely be in 2-3 with the Gigante or Indesu. Like, I would save, I could save a lot of time there and, you know, be pretty close to tied with Snow if I wanted to be, but it's not important. Out of all of these times, the 5-3 one is the one I'm most proud of, for sure. 6-2 is probably my second, and then 6-3 is my third, most likely, I would say, yeah. So here's the actual leaderboard. This is on normal, all chapters. And we can see that there I am. The priest one actually uses the fire glitch. So take like a minute, more than a minute off that time, and that's what you actually have. For priest, and I don't know what other glitches he used, but you can see Snow up there with the 110.20. Here's my friends list. So there's Snow, there's Outrage, there's CryingWolf, there's Alan Snyder, there's the Carpenter. And then I go back to all of them. So, yep, just Snow, me, Outrage, and CryingWolf. Those are the legit ones. That's 1, 2, 3, and 4. Priest isn't actually legit, but that's for Xbox. And then the other ones above that are all all fake as well. So, hope you guys enjoyed. Probably talked way too much or not enough. I don't know which. Thanks again for watching. My voice is kind of shot right now. Have a good one. Have a Merry Christmas. God bless and take care.